Philippine President Marcos Jr. says charges must be filed against officials who helped dismiss Mayor Alice Go escape from the country. He made the remark as Philippine law enforcement agencies are criticized for failing to capture the fugitive ex-mayor. Victoria Tulad reports.
All those who assisted dismissed Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Go in leaving the country will pay the price. This was the message of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. after Go was arrested in Indonesia on Wednesday.
Ang tanong niyo, sino yung sisibakin? Hindi lang namin sila sisibakin, kakasuhan pa namin sila. Dahil ang kanilang ginawa ay labag sa batas at against all of the interests of the Philippine judicial system.
The president also warned those who attempt to evade justice that the long arm of the law will catch up to them. He meanwhile thanked Philippine law enforcement authorities and the government of Indonesia.
The public may not know the intricate details of this mission that you have successfully accomplished, but on their behalf, accept my thanks. The Philippines also thanks the Indonesian government for their assistance on this matter. The close cooperation between our two governments has made this arrest possible.
Lawmakers leading the investigation on Philippine offshore gaming operators, or POGOs, praised the arrest of Go.
Definitely, ipinakita nitong pag-aresto kay Alice Go na tumakas ka man, pag pinaghahanap ka ng mga otoridad at may tulong pa ng mga otoridad ng ibang mga bansa, kahit dun ka pa tumakas, ay maibabalik ka din dito sa bansang Pilipinas.
I'm glad that she's now arrested and in the hands of the law. To those who are trying to evade arrest, you can run, but you cannot hide. Eventually, the long arm of the law will catch up on you.
There are, however, lawmakers who still criticized law enforcement agencies.
Nakakahiya to para sa enforcement agencies natin. Kung kukompare natin sa Indonesia, in 2 weeks, no, actually less than 2 weeks, nahuli na kaagad. Eh. But sa atin, 2 months. At nakatakas.
It's kind of an embarrassment to us because the Indonesian government is bent on arresting illegal aliens, no? While these people are being able to leave the country.
On Thursday, September 5, the Senate Subcommittee on Justice will hear the appeal of Ontiveros for the Department of Foreign Affairs to cancel Go's passport. On Monday, September 9, the Senate Committee on Women will continue its hearing on POGOs. Ontiveros hopes Go can attend the said inquiries.
Maaring hindi siya yung pinakamataas pa. Maaring hindi pa siya yung pinaka, kumbaga, malaking isda dito. At yun yung gustong tumbukin ng Committee on Women. Hindi na natin pauulitin na tumakas siya at may mga magkulang o worse, makipagsabwatan para patakasin siyang ulit.
Gatchalian wants to question Go on money laundering, the POGO hub in Bamban, and her possible accomplices.
Saan nang galing yung pera? At sino yung kanyang mga partners dito sa money laundering? Based sa mga intelligence reports na nakuha namin sa executive session, mayroong mga links na mga government officials at even enforcement agencies natin dito sa POGO hub sa Bamban.
Go will be detained in the Senate since it is the only one which has issued an arrest order against Go. According to the Office of the Senate Sergeant at Arms, Go will be turned over to them after being processed by the Bureau of Immigration and National Bureau of Investigation upon return to the country. The former mayor will be detained with Sheila Go, the Chinese earlier believed to be her sister.
I assure the safety talaga. And kung kailangan magdagdag ako ng personnel to guard them, 24/7, we will do it.
Go will not be allowed to use a cell phone while under Senate detention. If she does not cooperate, Gatchalian says, Go may be transferred to a regular detention cell. Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.